subject EV is 1. Standard 4th. Hello students, I am Elspeth Sibi and today we are going to learn the chapter Natural Disasters. What is the meaning of natural disasters? A natural event such as a flood, earthquake that cause great damage or loss of life. Can you tell which frightening natural events can be seen in the pictures below? A natural disaster is a major bad event caused by the natural processes of the earth, consisting of flood, volcano eruptions, earthquake, tsunamis, and other progress. And often human activities also may causes of natural disasters, such as climate change and deforestation is known as natural disaster. Can you tell? Sometimes during the rainy season, suddenly there is a downpour which lasts for 2 or 3 days. Downpour means heavy rains. You can see my image. A heavenly it is raining. And see how it has got flood. The river flows in full speed. See how the river is flowing in full swing. It may even overflow its banks and enter nearby settlements. What is the name given to such a rise in the level of river water? Let us see. Students, what you can see in my image? Yes, so many houses have destroyed due to earthquake. Name two places in Maharashtra where earthquakes have occurred. The main area affected was Maharashtra state in western India. Earthquake affected the district of Latur and Osamabad. 52 villages were demolished in the earthquake. An earthquake under the sea gives rise to very high waves. What are these gigantic waves called? Yes, it's called tsunami. Further, in my chapter, I will teach you in detail what is tsunami. Students, this concept you have already studied in English subject, your own book of science. Now we will also study in EVS 1. Let us check what is the meaning of hailstone. Many a time we hear of serious mishaps. Mishap means an unfortunate accident. An earthquake happens here. A flood occurs somewhere else. A storm. Storm means thunder. Occurs in one place. Another place is struck by lightning. See my image. You can see the lightning. There can be landslide or a hailstorm. Students, let us study in detail. What is the meaning of hailstorm? We feel very hot in summer. The sun shines brightly and the temperature is high. And then suddenly there are clouds in the sky and it starts raining. Not just water, but even small balls of ice. We say it has started hailing. The small balls of ice are called hailstones. Hey students, these are called as hailstones. Hailstones are formed when raindrops are carried upward by thunderstorm. Updrafts into extremely cold areas of the atmosphere and freeze. The hail falls when the thunderstorms updraft can no longer support the weight of the hailstone, which can occur if the stone becomes large enough or the updraft weakens. As we move up from the land, the temperature begins to fall. Up in the sky, it is very cold, even in the hot season. You know that there are water particles in the clouds that we see in the sky. Very high up in the sky, the water particles in the clouds turn into little bits of ice. Sometimes there are strong winds in the clouds. They push this little bits of ice upward, so they do not fall to the ground. They go up and collect more water particles, which freeze onto them. Thus, the tiny balls get bigger and bigger. They turn into hailstones. The heavy hailstones then fall to the ground in the form of a shower. Students, let us see how hailstones are formed. Hail formation and growth. Thunderstorm with strong sustained updraft. Small ice particles fall below freezing level, coated with water. Caught in updraft. Rises above freezing level. Cycle repeated until hailstone grows to large. Updraft unable to hold hailstone a lot, or it falls outside of updraft. Very tiny hailstones melt before they reach the ground. Students, you know that ice, when you take in your hand, it melts soon. So same it is with hailstones. They turn into raindrops, but some hailstones reach the ground before they melt. A light shower of hail can be great fun, but a hailstone can cause great damage in crops, plants, and animals. Maharashtra was hit by a serious hailstorms in 2014. The hailstorm devastated thousands of acres of standing crops. Students, see my image. How crops got destroyed. How animals got affected. Fruit crops were ruined. Birds and animals were killed and injured in large numbers. Farmers suffered heavy losses. It was a great natural calamity. In this incident, several people are injured. Some even lost their lives. House collapsed. Animals die. Standing crops get destroyed. There is a great damage to property. Day-to-day life is disturbed. It takes several days for life to get back to normal. A new term, disaster, a very serious mishap. Mishap means unfortunate accident, one in which people or animals can get injured or die. Crops and other property is destroyed. Houses collapse. Students, see my image, how animals are dying, how the crops got destroyed. This and some other mishaps have natural causes. They are called natural disasters. We do not have knowledge about when and where they might happen. Anytime any disaster can happen, we should be bold enough to handle that disaster. And it is impossible for us to prevent them. We must not get frightened by such disasters. Instead, it is more useful to find out how to face such a disaster if it happens. Students, when the disaster is going to occur, do not get worried. Fight as a brave student. Students, what you can see in my image? Yes, it's raining. Now, let us see what is the meaning of untimely rains. When it rains or other times, besides the monsoon or pre-monsoon period, such rain is said to be untimely rains. Untimely rains are never accepted. Any times it falls, and because of it, we get wet. In our country, we get rains only in a certain period of the year. In Maharashtra, it rains in the month of June, July, August, and September. This period is called the monsoon of the rainy season. In Maharashtra, on some day before the start of the rainy season, the sky suddenly gets overcast. There is lightning and thunder. It rains heavily for a short while. These are called pre-monsoon showers. Untimely rain comes without warning when we least expect it. People who have left their houses without umbrellas and raincoats have to run helter-skelter. See, this girl is getting wet. Why? Because of untimely rain. She didn't expect a rain now in this month and the girl got wet. Or we have to get soaked in the rain. But untimely rain can also cause serious damage. People grow winter crops. Occasionally, light showers are good for this crop. But if it rains too much, fields get waterlogged. Waterlogged means flood. And the crop may not cause much loss. Children, what you can see in my image? Yes, it's the flood. What is the meaning of flood? An overflow of large amount of water beyond its normal limits are known as flood. Sometimes during the monsoon, it rains heavily and continuously for 3 or 4 days. This causes the level of water in a river to rise. That is, the river gets flooded. If it does not stop raining, settlements on its banks can also get flooded. Mud houses on the river sides collapse. During a flood, people and animals may die due to drowning. Flooding of settlement causes problems in everyday life. At such times, we should go to a safe place at a height and come back only when the flood waters recede. The current of flood waters is very strong. It is dangerous to swim in the flood water. See, students, how it has got flooded, how people are walking in the flooded area. Do you think this water is safe for us? It can cause serious health issues. So students, what is this image? Yes, is the earthquake. Now we will study what is the meaning of earthquake in detail. Earthquake. Sometimes the rocks in the bowel of the earth move. As a result, waves are produced in the layers of rock. Students, see my image, how the road got collapsed. If a stone is thrown into the pool of still water, we see circular ripples around it. They move to the edges of the pool. After some time, the waves settle and the water becomes still as before. Exactly the same kind of waves are produced inside the earth. For a few seconds, the ground shakes. This is called the earthquake. Students, see my image, how the building got collapsed, how the roads are destroyed. These are called earthquakes. When the earthquake occurs, buildings are shaken. Things inside the house all fall from their places. Houses that are not strong enough simply collapse into heaps. Heaps means broken pieces. See the image, how the houses are broken into pieces. People get trapped under the heaps and get injured or even lost their life. The most damage occurs near the center of the earthquake. An earthquake also causes injuries or death of animals we keep. Students, here I have one method. How to be safe during earthquake? Let's see what is that safe method. How to save yourself from the earthquake? Do you know? If an earthquake occurs while you are at school, sit under your desk or bench. Once the quake stops, come out in single file and gather together in the open school ground. Crowding can cause more damage than the quake itself. So students, now we will study further. Tsunami. If the origin of the earthquake is in the sea, it produces gigantic sea waves. Each wave is the height of a 3 or 4 story building. These waves come with tremendous force towards the coast and crash into the land. These waves are called tsunamis. Students, let us study in detail. If the origin of the earthquake is in the sea, it produces gigantic sea waves. See what is the meaning of gigantic, how the waves are coming so fast. Each wave is a height of 3 or 4 story building. You know that what is the height of a building? So these waves are a height of that building. Can think how much huge, big it is. These waves come with tremendous force towards the coast and crash into the land. These waves are called tsunamis. Do you know, in every city and district headquarters, there's a fixed drill to be followed in case of natural disaster. In every area, there is a district or a headquarters to help us. If any fire occurs, there's a fireman to help us. If there is any flood occurring, there are so many people to help us. There are specially trained volunteers for that purpose. If necessary, soldiers of the army are also called to help. The fireman who help us in everything. So students, let us do a quick recap. What we have learned in the chapter. What we have learned. Rain that falls at times other than in the rainy season is called untimely rain. Fields become waterlogged and crops rot. Hailstorms may also occur with untimely rains. Hailstorms can injure people as well as animals. It damages crops and orchards. Orchards means farm. See, hailstorms, how they have injured the animals, how they had died. If it rains heavily during the rains, the level of water in the river rises. This is called a flood. Sometimes flood waters enter areas where people are living. Students, see my image. There is a house. See how water have entered the house. This is called flood. Houses collapse. People and animals drown and die. Everyday life becomes difficult. One should go to a place at a height till floods recede. See how the houses have dipped into the water, into the flood. Many people lost their lives due to this flood. Houses, animals, all die. It becomes very, very difficult to live during flood, during rain season. Some movements in the bowels of the earth give rise to waves. This is called an earthquake. It causes house to shake, things to fall down. Houses collapse into heaps. Students, see the image. How the building has got collapsed due to earthquake. People and animals get trapped in them and die. During an earthquake, one should sit under a table or bed or stand under a door frame. Whenever earthquake occurs, you should be in open ground space. They are telling us to sit under a table or a bed. We should not get scared of such disaster. We should be very bold to handle them alone. When an earthquake has its starting point in the sea, it gives rise to gigantic waves. They are called tsunamis. If they reach the human settlements on the shores, they cause great devastation. See how the tsunami has come to the building and how the building has collapsed, the people has collapsed. Always remember, we must obtain information about natural disasters to learn how we can prevent the loss that they cause. Students, I hope you understood the chapter. Thank you.